My name is Drew Parsons. I'm going to present to you the science of particle aggregation and colloidal stability. This introduces us to the theory of surface forces. First, some context. From biology, we have protein precipitation or protein coagulation. This is useful for separating proteins and purifying proteins. We can see in the illustration, in the photo, depending on the saline conditions in each file, we may get more or less protein precipitation. Other applications of aggregation come from mineral processing or from wastewater treatment, where we're trying to separate water from solid particulates. What drives aggregation? What are the main factors? What comes to mind? Why should two particles adhere together rather than bouncing off like billiard balls? First factor that might come to mind is particle charge. And that's certainly part of the story. What about adsorption of solid ions or solid molecules? Will that help or hinder aggregation? Another factor to consider is van der Waals forces. Same as the London dispersion forces between gas molecules, you can have van der Waals forces between particles. And they'll be attractive between identical particles. These ideas were put together in what we call the classic DLVO theory of the 20th century. This was developed separately by two teams, a team of Derriagin and Landau, Russian scientists in the former Soviet Union, who published in 1941, and the Dutch team, Overbeek, the PhD student of Fairway, working in the Netherlands. They published Overbeek's PhD thesis in 1948. You can see there's a gap between the two. The Russians were quite upset that the Dutch team didn't cite their work. They pointed out there was a little matter of a war at the time, which impeded access to the literature. So collectively today we call it DLVO theory. Thinking about particle charge, we've got the idea that opposites attract. If one particle is positive, the other negative, there will be an electrostatic attraction between them. But in solution, the general electrostatic interaction is not as simple as that. Consider identical particles with the same charge, say both positively charged. Will they repel? In air, certainly yes, but in solution, it's a bit more subtle. Hint to thinking about this is we're in aqueous solution, there's salt present, salt solution. What are those salt ions doing? Let's look at adsorption. We have an interaction force that's causing ions. The red circles represent ions or perhaps molecules. They're pulled in towards one surface or the other. So we have an adsorption layer, densification of the ions. We could evaluate the average concentration at each point away from the particle surface. So we have high concentration close to the surface. It falls back to bulk concentration. Then coming towards the other surface, the concentration picks up again. Consider what will happen if you bring those two surfaces together. You're trying to pack those ions into a smaller volume. Those adsorption layers will push against each other. They act as a kind of repulsive cushion, if you like. To get technical, this is an effect of entropy. By bringing the surfaces together, you're reducing the number of ways that you can place the ions. You're raising entropy, and that introduces a repulsive force. We can quantify that using the DLVO theory, or its more modern variants. There's a bit of physics, a bit of mathematics, which enables us to calculate what the various contributions are. Here we have an illustration of interaction between two microparticles in 1 millimolar potassium chloride solution. See, the van der Waals force is quite strongly attractive, but only at very close distances between the two particles. The direct electrostatic interaction due to charges is mildly attractive, not so strong. That's the green curve. Red curve represents the repulsive effect from the entropy of the adsorption layers as we bring them into contact with each other. That's quite strongly repulsive. We put those three factors together and we have the total force shown in black. What's the main feature there? We have a repulsive peak. So depending on, let's say, the kinetic energy at a given temperature of the particles, we may or may not be able to push past that repulsive peak. If the kinetic energy is low, if the temperature is low enough, we'll have a stable colloidal suspension. If the repulsive peak is low enough, then the particles can push into the primary minima driven by the van der Waals interaction. That's when we have strong aggregation. So basic ideas, what other factors are there? Effect of salt concentration. How will that affect the electrostatic potential and through it the overall surface forces? Concentration is quite an important factor. What else? Chemisorption, that's the question of where the charge on the particle comes from. It's typically related to pH. Other factors might include surface roughness or surface layers, perhaps a polymer coating. That's enough to think about for now. I'm happy to take your questions.